Hi everyone, and welcome to another Film Impact video tutorial. Are you ready to see another logo animation? This is the one we're gonna be creating today. So that is a very sleek and cool, modern looking logo reveal, right? So let's follow me by importing this logo inside Premiere Pro and have it animated. Now let's double click to import media and say, okay, this is the logo we want to import. And I've already prepared this logo in Photoshop because we want to have each element spread out on separate layers. So if you don't know how to work with EPS files or how to convert that to a Photoshop file, we have a separate tutorial on that. So from EPS to layered Photoshop file. So already done that. So all the layers, each element is being spread out, even the background here, letter B and so forth, lines, all different elements. Let's go back inside Premiere Pro. I just wanted to import this sequence. So again, I'm gonna just double click, import the PSD file. And now Premiere asks us what to do with all the layers. Now we wanna import that as a sequence. So as a sequence, click okay. And now just double click. Just move away. Yep. So double click the sequence here. And now, as you can see, I've got all the layers here being spread out. It's 32 tracks. And it's this logo. Okay, let's zoom in here. The tilde key will get us all the layers at once. I mean, have them visible here, so that's good. I mean, especially the upper ones are the lines corresponding to the yellows and the purple, what is it? Rose, whatever the color. You kind of have to look on or what to do with each element. And by looking at the logo, it could inspire you on what to do. Now it has all these diagonal lines, so you could think about slicing things up. Always start and look for the animation series. So dive into the effects library and find the Film Impact animation series. And so one thing you could do is, okay, move things around, or for instance, do a push that would move things. But I found the spring motion to be very elegant here. And at this stage, let's do full res so we can see that. Let's change the angle and do that. So change the angle. That would be sort of 45 degree angle. So that looks pretty good. Let's do a 90 degrees rotation there. So do a minus 45 and see how that works. And oh yeah, that looks good. Let's copy and paste this to each and every line here and see how that works. Okay, so it's doing a bouncy kind of thing. That's cool. What if we could do like one line reversed rotation on each line? So in Dutch, that will be om en om. So om en om, we're gonna spread out the lines and do reverse angle. Okay, this one we'll leave as is. Next one we'll do a reversed angle. And again, this one will be the same, and the latter we'll see how that works. Okay, so that's pretty good. And it's doing a bouncy kind of thing. You either want that. I mean, it's playful, but sometimes with logos, you kind of want to be straight and forward. So if you do that, I mean, let's do a straight and remove the amplitude here from the overshoot. Just set it to zero. Do it for everyone. I mean, I could do copy and then paste that one. So did I? Yep. And the same here. So just remove the amplitude. See if everything see if I've done things correctly just by checking. So here it should have zero amplitude, and it should have the reversed. So negative, it's not reversed. So this one should be reversed. Correct, amplitude set to zero. I'm just checking here. So if everything, okay, we've got the reversed angle there, and now things are looking perfect. All right. So this is good, right? But let's make it dynamic. And you've seen me doing this before. Just have a couple of frames offset. I'm going to select each layer and hit plus one on the keyboard. That will just do a shift of one frame. Do the same for the rest. So plus one, deselect one, plus one, plus one. And again, plus one. Okay, now we're having that timing offset, and see how that works. I mean, you could even do two frames or three frames, but this is actually pretty good. So this is a very nice and subtle way. We could even do lengthen this up. So just copy this one, do a paste here, paste, and do the same for this one. Copy, paste. I can see I'm missing a stair here. So let's select the upper layers here, plus one. There you go. Now we have a nice little stair going, and that indicates we've got, so just copying and pasting, making sure everything is correct. So the stair is here the same as well. So now we're doing good, right? So apparently I missed a spot here, so something turned off, which is, is this a three state? Wow, a three state. That's a bug in Premiere. Okay, it should not be a three state. Okay, but this is good. This is good. Perfect, right? So now let's see what we're going to do with the words. So we've got their brand name, and we've got the lorem ipsum galore, whatever how that is pronounced. But all these layers are here, and we could do isolated movements on each letter. But let's push things forward, and I'm going to merge all the layers together. So that will be nest, and this is the lorem ipsum logo text, just to make sure, and do the same for the brand name. So we're going to select all, right click, do nest brand name, and now we can kind of move things down so we don't have this enormous gap here. Okay, so remove the gap and see how that works. So we've got the brand name. Now, see what we're going to do with the brand name. I personally like the stretch wipe. I mean, you should definitely try that. Let's do the stretch wipe, and you can look for this stretch. Let's have this thing removed, yeah. So stretch wipe impacts on the brand name and see how that works. So now we've got... Ooh, yeah. I mean, that's powerful, right? It's doing a lot of glow around it, and it's doing kind of a stretch. Let's give it more room to breathe here. And the animation is going slower because we're building up layers, and this is sort of eating your I mean, it's asking a lot of your graphics hardware. So we could lower the resolution to half and see how that works. I just want to feel the timing is right. So I can see from this look, I'm not using over half of the video transition. So I might just as well go into the effects controls and say, have the transition start at 50%. So that would give it more time to see that happening. Okay, so that's good. And now we've got the lorem ipsum galore, and let's do a reveal there. Let's do a wipe. The wipe reveal is the impact wipe impacts is doing a lot of blur while it's wiping on the text. So there you go, it's doing a lot of blur. I think it's too much for this particular color because the text is rather small. So let's dial back the blur amount, but give it something because that will feel very smooth and elegant. And now look for the timing. I think this is kind of a subtitle. You want it to be revealed after the brand name, you know? So the brand name comes first. So you give that, you know, the most room to see, and then quickly reveal the subtitle. So as of now, we're kind of seeing the brand name, and from now we can have the alarm. Oh, that's actually pretty good. So let's see that in action. Oh, this is actually very nice. So there you go. So this is very, very elegant. Okay, and you could. Oh, this is very, very, very helpful. Okay, cool. Now we've got the basic logo animation. And what I recommend, don't stop here. Now this is the time to wrap things all together and create an entire nest of this sequence. Just select all. I'm pressing Command A on the keyboard. That's Control A for Windows users. And do a nest. I'm gonna name this basic logo reveal. Okay, now it's squeezing it all together. When I double click this this element, it just opens up the sequence here. Let's close it up. I've got it here, and now I can do other things with it, as in maybe do something. Okay, we've got the slicing things because we have all the graphic elements being spread out. Okay, slice it up, baby. Okay, slice impacts. Okay, slice impacts, see how that works. Okay, so this is slicing it up, but let's go with let's change the angle, right? Change the angle, got the transition selected here, go to the effects controls tab, angle. Okay, 45 degree angle, because that looks good on the logo. Let's increase the number of slices here. And we may want to lose the colorization amount. Just have the thing sliced over there. Okay, now see how that works. Okay, now we're doing good, right? So here again, I mean, I'm the actual visible transition here is just below a 50%. So I could do transition timing and start at say 30%, and that will start the animation all the way here, and that will be good. There you go. And now what I don't like is the slicing up here. So let's squeeze down the length of the transition and see how this works. So now it's sliced. Yeah, I don't no longer have the slices in the brand name, and see how that works as in timing. Oh yeah, and that's it. So now we've got a beautiful, powerful animation, and we could, if you just do it in and out and do a secret render into out, so we have a full res, full preview of this particular logo animation. I think it's going very well. This animation is looking very, very powerful. And you see, at the point where I say don't stop now, you're actually adding another element, and that's giving it that action, you know? So this is looking beautiful. And now this sequence is called 1, 2, 3, whatever. So let's have things named here. So I'm gonna rename this element logo reveal complete. Okay, that's good. And one thing I do see, because if I'm gonna drag this logo reveal complete into your final video, you're gonna find that things are being cut off here, exactly here. So one thing we're gonna do, that's the final thing. So the dot on the I, just have this thing selected, and again, do another nest. So logo, this is the advanced advanced, the sliced up logo reveal. And all you need to do is add a crop. You kind of need to feather out the edges here, because that will increase the uses of this particular logo animation. So crop, this is a basic crop. And now do a negative feather. So that will, let's see if I don't feather too much. If you do see feathering too much, now I see feathering too much because you can see kind of see the logo being faded away. So anything between minus 400 and zero will do. Let's do minus 200 and see how that works on the sliced up. And now you can see this is very nicely feathered out. And now we're ready. This is it. Thank you for watching. And please, if you do a logo reveal using the Film Impact premium tools, be sure to send us a message. I mean, post it on Facebook, tag us. We want to see those logo reveals coming in, because I hope this has inspired you. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.